right here the Bitmain Antminer S9, and then behind me and sitting underneath me is the Tesla Model S. What do these two have in common? Pretty much absolutely nothing, except they're kind of like the future technology kind of thing. But picture has been circulating around the internet and also different news forums. I've even seen it in newspapers and on TV. A picture that someone was actually transporting Bitcoin mining or cryptocurrency mining equipment in his trunk. Well, the news, of course, takes that picture, spins it completely out of proportion, and makes up a fake news story that just seems to keep going and going and going. And that news story is, oh, he's stealing power from superchargers in order to mine cryptocurrency for free. I've already done two videos on this subject, one explaining why it's completely idiotic and stupid idea, and video number two, kind of what you'd have to go through to actually make something like that work, which just reinforces video number one, showing that it's a completely stupid and idiotic idea. Well, my viewers wanted me to actually try it. So here we have the Bitmain Antminer S9, the most efficient, commonly readily available Bitcoin mining computer out on the market. This little bugger right here can do 13.5 terahashes per second calculations to mine Bitcoin. That's a lot. It also has the lowest power consumption per terahash or per hash. So, considering this is the most efficient Bitcoin mining computer, and this is pretty much the most efficient vehicle, or one of the most efficient vehicles in the world, let's give it a go. Now, at full power, this thing will draw just a hair under 1400 watts of power. You can run it off 120 or 240 volts, but 120 volt outlet just isn't going to provide the unit with just what it needs. So we have a 240 volt power inverter, DC to DC, or DC to AC inverter right here. It's got a 1500 watt sustained capacity with a burst of 3000 watts. I can tell you right now, this thing does not draw, even on burst and startup, 3000 watts. And I have verified the capacity of my inverter. Even though it's a little on the small side, it did manage to run a 1500 watt load for about a half hour for me before the battery it was connected to was dead. Now, one thing I need to note, we're connecting to the 12 volt auxiliary battery on the car, since there's no reasonable way to tap into the high voltage battery pack. And then even if we did, we'd still need other electronics, another DC to DC converter of a sizable capacity to bring the voltage down, and then we'd still have to find a way to connect it to the Antminer. That being said, there's also another problem. The DC to DC converter that's already in the car that recharges the 12 volt battery off the high voltage battery has approximately a 600 watt capacity. Even if the car manages to power the Antminer S9, the little problem is we're going to exhaust that 12 volt battery faster than what the car can replenish it at. But let's just try it anyways. And another thing I can do is there's three hash boards in this Antminer S9. Well, first we'll try it with all three. If it doesn't work, we'll try it with two, and then we'll try it with one, and I'll tell you our conclusions after that. So, let's lower her in here. Now, if I was actually setting this up to sit at a cheap supercharger and do, I would then have some sort of Wi-Fi hotspot going over the cellular network. But we're not doing it, and I already can tell you right now, this is an idiotic idea and it ain't gonna really work. So instead, I ran a 50 foot Ethernet cord. I plugged that in here. There we go, that's in. Got the power supply. The inverter is on. Green lights go. Now, you guys can already hear in the background fans running. Those are three other Antminer S9s running in my house. Or actually my garage for the moment. I'm making use of this ultra cold weather. Move the camera a little closer here. And that's three of them about 30 feet away through other stuff in my garage. This is going to get loud. Okay, folks? Adjust my camera there. Okay. Now I also have my Dell Mini 9 right there, so we can monitor this computer. I got it set up for the correct monitoring page for here. All right, here we go. Fans are starting up. It's going through its boot sequence right now. The green lights are on. Now, if it does shut off, I'm going to kill the power on the power supply quickly if for some reason there's a power failure. Because the inverter is self-resetting. And I don't want to fry a very expensive mining computer here. The miner fans are now kicking in. They go up to as much as 6,000 RPM. One Antminer can put out as much heat as a 1,500 watt space heater. Actually, somewhere in a range of about 4,500 to 5,000 BTU. So I'm actually working on a little project. I'm going to turn one of these into a heater for my house since it's running anyways. I'm going to check the computer. Okay, the Antminer is online and on my network, and it is displaying the stats page, but it is not doing any mining as of yet. There we go. All right, and it just killed. All right, killed the power supply. So, trial one. I guess the voltage dip was just a little bit too much or something, I don't know. Let's try removing and disconnecting power to one of the hash boards. Try again. All right, booting up. Man, is it cold out here. 15 degrees Fahrenheit right now, folks. Woo-hoo. Let's put it this way. These things kick out so much heat. With four of these running in my garage, 15 degrees outside, my garage was a balmy 65 degrees Fahrenheit. Miner fans are up and running. No fault lights yet. Sometimes it doesn't like having hash boards connect disconnected. So right now we're using 450 watts. So right now, with one board disconnected, we are down to 900 watts. Still not mining yet. No fault line yet. Blinking on the control board. So, can't do 900 watts worth. Last try. Now, theoretically, okay, now we're down to one hash board. Turn her on. Theoretically, 450 watt draw. Technically, the car should be able to support this indefinitely. But, let's see, 13.5 terahashes divided by 3. I guess that's 4.5 terahashes with just one board running. Now we run into the next problem is the hash rate is so low. If you went through all the pain in the butt to do this, getting free electric, you're going to go through all this hassle to make about, well, right now, based on right now spot price for Bitcoin to US dollar conversion, you're going to make about $150 a month going through the pain in the ass of stealing electric or borrowing electric or using electric from a supercharger to try and mine Bitcoin. Tell me, is that really worth the hassle? Now, if you could keep the whole thing running full blast, yeah, you might make it worthwhile, but you're going to waste so much time. Spinning up a little bit more. There's network traffic lights. And something just happened. One hashboard is running. So it is running the hashboard. But nothing's mining. Oh. Nah, it's just not doing it. I think we're gonna have to call this one. Fault light, no fault light. Just not cutting it. Alright, we're gonna power that down. Yeah, that's just not cutting it. Well, we gave it a try. This just isn't practical, nor is it, well, it's not really profitable either. because just in the amount of time this thing's been sitting offline in my trunk of my car, I've probably lost more money than I would have gained if it actually ran. So we're calling it. It's a neat idea, but it's stupid. I mean, it's something fun to try, but there's just no point in doing it. It's just not. Don't waste your time. But we did it. I mean, who else is stupid enough to actually try and actually mine Bitcoin with a Tesla Model S? Me. Now, that being said, here is my call to Elon Musk. With over 1,100 different kinds of cryptocurrency out there now, 1,100 different kinds of coins, and more being created every day, Elon, I call to you. Please, have your minions make a Tesla coin. Remember whose idea it was, so I get the initial ICO, maybe a few bonus coins off the start here, but maybe have a Tesla coin that we can use as Tesla owners. With the amount of processing power in these cars, especially starting with the Autopilot 2 vehicles, and the GPUs that are in these cars, and all that other good stuff, maybe we could put to use some of the idle power while the cars are plugged in, fully charged, and not doing anything to mine Tesla coin cryptocurrency. Hey, how's that sound? Is that a neat idea? No? Yes? Maybe? What do you guys think? What do you think? My viewers, what do you think of this whole ordeal and pain in the butt? Please comment in the comment section below. If you'd like to support my channel, please don't forget, hit the like button if you liked the video, hit the thumbs down button if you didn't like the video, share the video if you can, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already for more stupid ideas and crazy videos and Tesla related stuff. If you want to help support the channel, please consider contributing to my Patreon. And this link's in the description box below, or mine some Monero. Link to that is also in the description box below. Monero cryptocurrency, you can mine it with your browser. Nothing needs to be installed or done. Just open the web page, hit mine, and leave it run overnight. Every little bit helps. It's not much, but it's something fun and easy to do. See you all later.